Welcome to Word, weekly passwords to the riddles of our lives. I'm Amichai Lau Lavi here in Harlem, and I'm sharing another way for us to deconstruct and analyze patriarchy to better use, one word at a time. This week, we are following an ancestor who is traumatized and who's found a way to breathe better and to ground and to be nature as a way to respond to all the stresses of our lives. We're talking about Isaac, Yitzchak, the second of our patriarchs, who was offered by his father as a sacrifice, has just lost his mother. He's single, kind of 40 years at home, and he's trying to find ways to be more grounded. So he does what I've been doing so many days during COVID with the luck of having a backyard. I'm here under the cherry tree that is losing its leaves, but there's still a shelter. And that's what Isaac has been doing. He does something that Genesis 24:63 describes as Vayetze Yitzchak Lasuach Basadeh. Isaac goes out into the field to Lasuach, to meditate, to stroll, to talk to the trees, to talk to himself. Isaac does something that the translators are arguing about, but if you look closely, what he's doing is probably mindfulness in nature. He takes time to appreciate the sunset, appreciate the fallen leaves, take a breath, catch a breath, and take agency over stress and fear to be more here and now. We often think that meditation comes from the East, and it does. And yet the Bible gives us just one of these many tools for us to be more grounded, more aligned, more here and now. Vayetze Yitzchak Lasuach Basadeh means he's becoming one with the bushes. He's talking with creation. He is breathing and being and finding ways to really, really, truly be more here and now. I'm so grateful for the ways that I've been taught how to ground, and I'm glad that it's in my tradition and in so many of ours. So on this day, into this Shabbat, however you are, I hope you find ways to lasuach, to talk with presence, to find a way to go inside, to hug a tree or bush, or just close your eyes and take a breath. Or two, into Shabbat. Thank you, Isaac, for the role modeling. Oh, and by the way, as soon as he does it, a caravan of camels comes from across the horizon, and on it is the woman he will marry and will love, Rebecca. It is party time. Romance, love can maybe come when we are more here now and grounded. No promises. Shabbat Shalom. See you next week at Word, one weekly password to the riddles of our lives. Thank you for joining.